So let's look at another previous problem from this topic, quadratic equations and expressions. So it says, how many real solutions does this equation x power 7 plus 14x power 5 plus 16x cube plus 30x minus 560 have? So the thing here is, these problems, this is a 7th degree polynomial, right? So it's a 7th degree polynomial. So what you have to understand about this is, it can have 7 roots at max. So at max it can have 7 roots, but not more than 7, right? So it can have less than 7 also, right? But at max it can have 7 roots. These roots, all of these 7 roots can be real or complex. Or it can be a mixture of both. So as in, you might have first root as real, second and third as complex, fourth as real, fifth and sixth as complex, something like that. But the one thing that you have to know is, complex roots always occur in conjugate pairs, which means if a plus ib is a complex root to this equation, then a minus ib also will be a root to this equation. So it will always occur in pairs. You can't just have a minus ib satisfying this. If you have a plus ib satisfying this, then a minus ib also has to satisfy that, right? So it always occurs in pairs. So that means the number of complex roots can never be odd. It has to be even. So you can either have 2 complex roots, or you can have 4 complex roots, or you can have 6 complex roots, but it's never possible for you to have 1 complex root only and the rest real. You can't have 3 complex roots and the rest real, because they always occur in pairs, right? So you can't have 1. If 1 is there, then the other complex also will be a root, right? The conjugate pair will be a root, so you will have 2. So that is what I mean to say. So here, let's look at how many roots are there to this equation. For that, what we always do is, to find out, to do such problems, we first differentiate this function. Let's see what we get when we differentiate. So f dash x is equals to 7x power 6 plus 14 into 5, which is 70x power 4 plus 48x square is equals to, you just need this, frankly. You just need this differential. As you can see, no matter what value of x I give to it, except x equal to 0. No matter what value I keep giving to this expression, in fact, you have a 30 also. I forgot about the 30. This quantity f dash x is always greater than 0. It's never even equal to 0. Why? Because even if I give 0 to this, you'll have 30 as the value. And if I give anything other than 0, be it plus or minus, this will be positive, right? So it will always add to 30. So your f dash x is always greater than 0. It's never 0. So let's see, when does an equation have a root? When an equation has a root, for example, if you have a cubic equation, it will cut here only if this curve turns. Only then it will have roots, right? So it has to turn. The point where it turns, your f dash x will be 0 at that point. So the number of times f dash x becomes 0, those many turns the curve will take. And the number of turns it takes, those many roots it can have, something like that. You have to have that sort of an understanding. So here, as you can see, because f dash x is continuously greater than 0, that means the function doesn't turn at all. This function that you see here doesn't turn at all. So I can say that, after this, what can I say about the root? So there's one more thing that you need to analyze. You have 7 roots here. Right, you have 7 roots here. Can you have all 7 complex? Right, so the fact here is, the moment the function turns, it cuts. And only when it cuts the x-axis, I will say real roots exist, right? Here I am telling you that the function doesn't turn at all. Does that mean all the 7 roots are complex? No, because complex roots always have to be even. They can't be 7. Because you can have 1 plus 1, 2. You can have the other pair. You can have one more pair, so you can have 6 here. 7th one can't exist alone, right? Because you have to have 8, you have to have its conjugate also. That means these are all complex, but there is one real root which will always be there, right? So there is one real root which will always be there for an odd degree polynomial. You can't have, so for a cubic polynomial also, for a cubic polynomial also, you can't have three complex roots. You can either have one real, two complex, or all three real, because complex numbers, complex roots always have to be even. So here, as you can see, because all seven can't be complex, I will say one minimum is real, and that's always the case, and the other six are all complex, and they're all pairs of three, right? So 2, 2, 2, 6, and they're all complex, and one is real. So I will say it just has one real root.